Thank you. Now you can all go home. No. My name is Lauren Kajikawa. For those of you that don't know me, I'm the program head here in music at the Corcoran School of the Arts and Design at George Washington University. And it's really great that you're all here today for our Friday at 5. This is our second to the last Friday at 5 of the semester. There'll be one more opportunity for you to sign up and perform on December 2nd. So please do that if you're thinking about, you know, something that you want to share. The more the merrier, and looking forward to hearing and seeing what you have to share with us. One quick announcement at the top. The Corcoran Music Festival is coming up next weekend, starting next Friday, November 11th. So you'll see posters like this all around. Yeah, I brought my visual aid with me today. All around the hallway. We'll be sending out announcements via our news list, our newsletter and email list with links with more information about that. But this is an opportunity for you to see some of our really talented faculty perform, in addition to some of our student ensembles as well. But mainly, the purpose of this festival is to really showcase the work of our incredibly talented performance faculty. So hopefully, I'll get to see many of you at next Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, 4 days of music here at GW. The last thing before I get out of here is just to give thanks, as always, to the people that make this possible, Caitlin for the pizza and organizing all this, so please enjoy that while you can. Yep. Our team of work study students, and Professor Heather Stebbins for helping out with the sound tonight, and of course Patrick Merrill, who is going to be running the show after I get out of the way. But first, we're going to go right into something by Mariana Souza, who's going to come up and tell you a little bit about this piece. And for some of the things that have video tonight, also, you may want to rotate your chair 90 degrees to be able to see on the screen. But Mariana?
Hello, everybody. Thanks for coming today. I'm going to present some of the pieces that I composed for video games. So my instrument is the computer, and I hope you enjoy it. It will be 4 pieces. Thank you so much. Thank you.
now for something completely different. But our arpeggionist.
Hello, my name is Josh, and I'll be playing Schubert's Arpeggione Sonata, written in 1824, and this is the last movement. And this piece was originally written for the arpeggione instrument, which is like a kind of like a six-string cello. And it has since been adapted by the cello and the viola. So hope you enjoy.
We're getting a stand for you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So the piece we'll be playing today is the first movement of the Serenade, Opus 24, by Danish composer Emil Hartmann. Hartmann was a Romantic era composer who lived from 1836 to 1898, and in his lifetime he composed multiple symphonies, concertos, overtures, and pieces of chamber music. The piano trio we will be playing today was originally written for piano, cello, and clarinet, but here we have an arrangement that has Josh on the viola replacing the clarinet, so hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Chopin. It is part of Opus 17, and it is the fourth and final mazurka in the opus. It is Marc's Lento ma non troppo. After leaving his homeland of Poland at age 20 in 1830 and residing in Paris, Chopin was unable to return to Poland since it was at war. His pieces, particularly his mazurkas and polonaises, allowed him to express his Polish heritage away from home, and the mazurka in particular, a traditional Polish dance, Chopin then made his own style. And then between 1825 and his death in 1849, Chopin wrote nearly 60 mazurkas, and the one I'm playing for you today is one of the earliest published in 1832. So, if you enjoy.
Thank you. at GW, and today I'll be singing Le Colibri by Ernest Chausson and Le Comte de Lille. This song captures the beauty of love in its natural forms, specifically talking about love in terms of a green hummingbird flying over the hills. He's the king, and he drinks one day too much of a flower, and he unfortunately dies. So it kind of resembles this love, death, and passion all in one.
Two pieces that were published after their composers' deaths. So for Franz Schubert, he died in 1828, really young, and Sension is a love song from a book of Lieder called Schwangesang, which means swan songs. It was a collection of pieces that just weren't published yet, and they were when he died. And the second piece is a French aria, Elle a fui la tortorelle, from Offenbach's The Tales of the Hoffman, or Le Comte de Hoffmann. My French isn't great. And it is the whole opera is the story of Hoffman and all of his romantic love interests. And this aria, it comes from one of them, Antonia. And for both pieces, that's really interesting is they're both really have the same poetic idea that I'm in love with you, I'm here, I really hope you're thinking about me because I'm thinking about you, and I really hope that you can come be with me. So we have a theme, and with that, oh, also, because I'm doing two, please hold your applause, just so we can keep it moving tonight. So with that, hope you enjoy.
Thank you. I'm a sophomore studying music here. I am going to be singing The Vagabond by Ray Vaughan Williams, who was an English composer around the turn of the 20th century. And this is from his song cycle, Songs of Travel. It's the very first song, kind of sets the pace, tone of the song cycle about traveling. It's a poem by Robert Louis Stevenson? One of the two? Oh, I'm sorry. And all of the song cycle is composed of poems by him, and it's a cool cycle. So I'll be singing The Vagabond by Ray Vaughan Williams. Give to me the life I love, let the leaf go by. Bread in the bush with stars to see, bread.
So my name is Michael. I will be doing Enfermant les yeux from Manon. And so it translates to when closing your eyes or closing your eyes. It's also known as le rêve or the dream. I play the role of Les Chevaliers de Crieu, who falls in love with Manon, but I'm like low level royalty and she's supposed to be someone who's like high level royalty. So we can't be together, but I sing this song about if our life was together, and at the end I say it would be so good, you know, if only you were there.
Ma tête est folle, mais le bonheur est passager et le ciel a fait si léger qu'on a toujours peur qu'il s'envole. A table, a table. Les ombres
Thank you. not very good at naming anything, but that's all I have to say.
Thank you. Thank you. amazing opportunity this summer to study in Spain. I studied in the city of Granada, and Granada is a beautiful, beautiful city in the region of Andalusia. Andalusia is this area of Spain in the south, right over Morocco. It has a beautiful, amazing, multicultural history. The city that I was in was one of the longest strongholds of the Moors within Andalusia. It's known for its Alhambra, its beautiful architecture, its amazing food, amazing wine, amazing people. I was there during the summer. It was hot, really hot. Every day it would be over 100 degrees. I'd be walking back and forth, you know, Spanish, they're known for the siesta, right? And it's so hot that all you can do is sleep, to sleep away the heat of the day, the intense light that you get from the sun. This first one I'll be doing is representative of that. It's called the Solea, Sol, the sun. Within it, I hope you can hear the heat that was emitted there off the white walls that brought me into this beautiful, beautiful passionate state and created my love for flamenco. Thank you. day that you, you know, just couldn't go out. But then the sun would go down, and I would go down. I lived in an area called the Albaicin. The Albaicin was this, you know, old area, primarily for the gitanos that the, you know, flamenco is known for. Gitanos are the Romani people of Andalusia, and they know how to party really well. You'd go down there, and the wine would be flowing. You know, everyone would be up dancing. Everyone would be up singing. It was lively. It was joyous. It was, you know, beautiful, beautiful passion at work. There's a term in flamenco called duende, which translated means goblin, but it's the spirit of the party that comes alive and imbues itself into your guitar, imbues itself into the music, and that's what makes flamenco so beautifully passionate. And now, to raise the tempo a little, I'm doing a tango de Triana. Triana was one of the areas that the gitanos lived in. Please enjoy. If you want to dance, dance. If you want to get ole, get ole.
Okay, so I'm supposed to top that. That's not fair. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is Kaustub, and today I'll be singing De Vieni alla Finestra, which is an aria from the opera Don Giovanni, written by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart in 1787, based off of the libretto of Lorenzo da Ponte. So in this opera, we are introduced to a despicable man. Someone who is full of sexual promiscuity, and he basically believes that he has a license to do anything he wants in a world that has shown him very little consequences. In this opera, we follow him through his terrible deeds, including murder and rape, until he reaches a final reckoning. The song I'll be singing today is actually a serenade that he sings for the mate of one of the noble ladies in the opera, Donna Elvira. Now, what I found so fascinating was, yes, this guy is probably the worst man to walk the face of the earth, and yet the audience is, like, for just a brief moment, captivated by this wonderful nobleman who is faking his deep love while playing his mandolin. I really think this is a testament to Mozart's brilliance, who he's able to show even an ounce of humanity in someone who's just extremely harrowing to watch in the whole opera. With that, I'll stop talking, and I hope you enjoy my performance.
Show takes place over his trial, and and the victim's mother goes up to the stand to testify. She sings.
Child. child will be watching me. Give him faith in the future that's golden and new. My Mary will teach me to open my heart, and so I forgive you too.
That was really good. Hey guys, my name is Nadia Lischke. I'm a junior studying biology and music. And today I've got two things for you. The first is called Auch Kleine Dinge by Hugo Wolf, and it's talking about how even the smallest things carry a lot of worth, specifically like a pearl and a rose and etc. So yeah. Cheryl originally, and then Julie London kind of popularized it. So, yeah.
Thank you. this is the second sonata that Brahms wrote, and it was dedicated to a man named Robert Hausmann, who popularized the first sonata, so to show his appreciation, Brahms wrote a second one devoted to him so he could play it with his, along with his quartet. He's a German composer who lived through the mid to late 1800s, and for this one, I'm just playing the fourth movement, which is a rondo, so it's characterized by a predominant melody that you'll hear about the beginning, the middle, and around the end, as well as a lot of contrasting melodies with the piano. So hope you enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
thanks to all the performers, and of course, thanks to Professor Patrick Barrow.
Great. One, two, three. One, two, three. One more.